Hey there everybody, it's time for some new update videos. I've been busy traveling and filming tons of derbies. Now we're finally going to make some projects happen around the house. But first off, I wanted to give you guys a bit of disappointing news and fill you in a little bit of the backstory of what's going on. I won't give you the full scoop, but unfortunately you will notice this is the green Lumina, the one that's been ran once by me and once again by Big Lair, who tried to finish it off and it survived. And the plan originally was to have Big Lair come back, drive this green Lumina again in another demolition derby this summer or this fall. It was going to be pretty cool to see it finally just get destroyed. He wasn't going to try to win with it. We just want to see how much damage we could do to the car. But unfortunately, we have to announce an unforeseen retirement of Big Lair. He will no longer be joining us driving demolition derby cars. He will still be here in videos with us. He's still going to come to the derbies with us. But several weeks ago, we had a very big scare in our family. And we had a very big medical emergency involving him. And we found out he has some serious heart conditions that need to get taken care of. And because of those issues, he will no longer be capable of driving in demolition derbies for the rest of his life, is what I'm gathering. So wish him the best of luck. He will be having heart surgery sometime in the future. So hopefully we will get things taken care of. He will be good to go again. We can get him back here on some videos. It's just a really good thing we were able to put him in these derbies when he had the chance. And he was able to drive his very first ever demolition derby car, which was that Chrysler New Yorker from the 90s. That was that white car we ran long ago, many years ago in Franklin, Indiana. And he ran in his second ever demolition derby with this green Lumina here that he was running for my pre-ran. So at least he got those two runs in him. You know, like I said, unfortunately, he will not be back again to finish this car off. So I am planning to run this car sometime in his honor. You know, he'll come watch it and, you know, get a kick out of seeing this thing get destroyed. We're not going to try to win with it. We're just going to have fun and see how much damage we can cause to the front of this car until it completely shuts down or blows apart. So just wanted to give you guys a quick update on that, of what's going on. We've had some craziness in the last couple weeks of just stuff happening around the family. So things are getting cleared up, and hopefully things will all be good in the future. But in other news, let's continue on to the other cars. You will also notice I still have my wagon here. Many people keep asking me, hey, where was the derby for the wagon? Why didn't you run it? The wagon was supposed to have already run in a demolition derby back in June. If you guys have not seen the video, go watch the video of the wasted derby weekend. And that's just all the craziness that happened when this thing was supposed to run. A bunch of rainstorms, we had flooding, a bunch of vents were having problems getting canceled. We had our actual tow vehicle and the trailer sink and get stuck in the mud. A lot of bad things happened all at once at that weekend, so this vehicle did not get ran. This wagon will run in 2019. I already know where I'm bringing it. I already talked to the promoters that I'm going to bring it to. I have permission to bring it there. It's going to pass all my stuff. No worries about my build for the rules. So I'm happy for that. So I'll reveal more of that come next year at the beginning of derby season for 2019. But you will notice I have not been running in any demolition derbies this year. And that is intentional, I will tell you that. My plan was to only run one demolition derby this year, and that was going to be with the Ghostbusters wagon. But since that did not happen, that was my only event to run, and that is it for me. Now, Susan did run the Cutlass this year, and she would have ran this Grand Am earlier this year had it not had the engine problems it had. But you'll see we still have the Grand Am sitting here. We did not scrap it. And this car will be returning to the Demolition Derby Arena this year. It's going to go back to the Pavement Demolition Derby, the Indianapolis Speedrome, the event that I am now promoter of and in charge of. So we're going to bring this car back, send it off, we're going to make sure it runs good before we bring it there, and it will get junked and destroyed. And the fun thing about this car is, it's not going to be a car that's going to place. There's no way this car is going to get first place, no way it's going to get top three, and that is because we are not running a radiator in this car, we are not running looped hoses, we are running no water whatsoever. All we're going to do to the front of this thing is stick an AC condenser back on the front to protect the wires, and bolt the bumper back on the front. Throw the hood on it, and we are going to go. That is it. So this car is going to have a very limited amount of time in the arena before that engine either blows up or shuts down. So Susan's going to go out there and just have fun and destroy this car, because that engine has a cracked block. And if you put any water in there, it just floods the cylinders out, so you can't even loop the hoses at all. Any amount of water that you pour straight into the tubes, the filler neck, straight into the engine, will just lock up them cylinders with water. So, instead of just scrapping the car, you know, and sending it to the junkyard and getting scrap money from it, let's at least run it, we will have fun, destroy the car, then we will scrap it. So, stay tuned for that coming up mid-September, guys. That will be probably the last event that we're going to be driving cars in for this year. But yeah, back to me, as I was saying, I only had planned to run one event this year. And the reason for that is because I decided way early on in the beginning of this Demolition Derby season, I had my pre-rans and I didn't know what I was going to do with them or where I wanted to bring them. And I got to sitting and talking and thinking, and I've realized, guys, we have had this Demolition Derby shop for 2 years now, actually being above ground built. We have the concrete in it, and we are still not using that shop to build our cars in. I'm still trying to cram cars in my little cinder block garage that should have been for my normal vehicles. We're still working out of this tiny garage, and we don't have that shop completely finished yet to work out of. So I decided I was going to spend this entire summer working on that shop, getting everything done in there, installing all the stuff I need to do in there, getting electric in it, insulation in the walls, insulation in the ceilings, all the stuff I need to be able to use that shop, because it sucks to have a new building and not even be able to use it. You're just looking at it. So by me running in derbies and constantly trying to build cars, it was going to eat up all of my free time and extra money and resources doing that. So instead, I devoted all that money and all that time to working on my shop. So stay tuned, the next video I upload is going to be the next update to my Derby Shop series, part 7, 8, or whatever is next in the series, and you'll see all the progress I have now made on that shop, which is a pretty good amount, and even more stuff still coming this fall to that building. So I figured I would just do as much as I can on that, get it done and over with. That's the way next year we can officially go full swing, we can go back to building cars, running cars, and we will have plenty of room and a nice building to be working out of. With that being said, I did try to make up for it, and that is why you will notice I have been filming and uploading a ton of Demolition Derby videos. Me and Susan traveled all around Indiana, you know, we filmed a ton of events, many new events that we never even went to before, just to check them out. We wanted to get an idea for future events for next year where we might want to go. So that's pretty cool, and I also wanted to have something for you guys to watch. If I'm not filming videos on building cars, I'm at least going to travel and film videos of derbies for you guys to have something to watch. So there's always going to be something new, some derby content on my channel. I will promise that and keep something going. So also, something I have mentioned, don't think I've gone into full detail about with future derby cars. I mentioned it before that our local promoter is going to be done promoting at the end of this season for Demolition Derby, and new people will be taking over his promoting business. Now, he has mentioned that the rules should not, and I quote, should not be changing as far as what I run with the front-wheel drive class, but there's no guarantee. So this is why I have not built any other fresh cars, because if I build them to those rules, I may have a whole bunch of fresh cars on my hands that cannot run at any of those events if they drastically change anything that's allowed. That's also why me and Susan took the time to travel and check out a couple of new events and their rules and how they function. So I have a couple pre-rans that are sitting around, and I have a good idea where I can bring them if I need to, and the rules keep changing around here. So it's just been a big year of changes for us, guys. Hopefully we'll get through it. Hopefully next year will be even bigger and better with all the new advancements that we will have. And hopefully I have a few surprises to still reveal along the way. So, I'm going to go get back over in the shop, get some more work done on it. You guys stay tuned. I have big changes for the Demolition Derby shop. Can't wait to see the next Derby update on what we've all done.